You have any question regarding any subject, you can type it on the chat box. Also, I'll be sharing a Google link with everyone after the session, so you can write the questions there also. And you can personally contact me or the subject teacher for any query that you have. So let's start it over. Over to you, Pooja ma'am. Oh, Pooja ma'am is going to talk about informatic practices.
Thank you, Vansi ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, students. So I'll just share my screen. Please let me know, is the screen visible? I'll just share it again because there's some issue coming here. Just give me 1 second. I am unable to get the screen. All right, there it is. Is the presentation visible?
Not yet.
Yeah, the screen sharing is paused, it says. There is some issue. It says the screen sharing is paused for some reason. I'll try to share again. All right, I think I should be able to do it now.
Students, I'll repeat again. Please turn on your cameras.
I think now it's visible.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So I will be talking about the subject, as Mansi ma'am mentioned, informatics practices. So let me just give you a brief into what these terms mean. Informatics basically means information science. So dealing with information in any way, trying to process it, then trying to get some inference out of the information, that is the science of information, and that is the term informatics, or that is what the term informatics means. Now, putting that into practice means whatever information science you've worked on, putting it into practice for making informed decisions, whether it is in the any business sector, any real world problem, that is the entire subject all about. So the content of the subject, the main categories under which the content will be studied are computer system concepts. Then you will have Python programming. That's the new programming language which you will be learning. Then database concepts, and the software on which we will be learning the database concepts is MySQL. So you all are in class 10th right now, students, and you are already doing OpenOffice.org base, which is a database, which is an RDBMS. So in 11th, if you take up this subject, you will be studying MySQL. Concepts stay the same. Language stays the same, which is structured query language. The way of implementing it changes because the software is different. Then we will be studying about networking. Definitely, what are the types of networks? What kind of networks do we need in our homes, in our offices, in the city, in the country? And what are the various ways the networks are made in? Then emerging trends in IT, and societal impacts of IT. So the entire content of this subject over the duration of 2 years is studied under these major topics. So let me just tell you, the scheme of the study is you have a theory exam for 70 marks, then practical of 30. And in class 12th, this practical of 30 marks includes a project which is based again on a real world application. So you will be developing a mini software, an application program, out of the topics that you have studied, which is Python and MySQL. Now, why is Python so important now? You must have heard Python everywhere. And even CBSE introduced Python in the curriculum for 11th and 12th 3 years back, because it is in great demand in the IT industry. It is the buzzword today. What is the reason for that is it is very simple to learn. So that should give you a very good start. It's very simple to learn with a lot of predefined functions and libraries. That is for your programming capability to be able to use a programming language to develop a software. There are certain functionalities which are already built in Python. All you need to do is learn how to just use them in your program. So you don't have to write a program right from scratch. The facilities, the tools, the functions are already given to you. You just need to know, okay, this is where I need to use it. That's it. Then whatever emerging trend we talk about, we cannot miss artificial intelligence and machine learning, which is a related concept. So Python is used in programming for artificial intelligence and in machine learning. It is widely used in these two fields also. Then IP as a subject will enable you to learn how to apply the tools of Python, which you will learn for data analysis. As we've already spoken about that informatics means information science, and information cannot be derived without data. So if you have a huge amount of data and you want to apply certain tools on the data for the purpose of analyzing the data, there are tools available which you will be using to do so. So there will be certain statistical analysis such as mean, mode, median, variance, covariance. All these maybe you'll learn in other subjects also, but how to apply the programming concept and get that meaningful information, that you will learn in this subject using Python. MySQL, I've already given you a brief of how it works. It's just like OpenOffice.org base that you're currently studying in class 10th. Now, why should a student take up IP as a subject? First, if you have a logical aptitude, you love reasoning, you like to find a solution to a problem, this is a subject for you. If you have an interest in these kind of reasonings, please take up the subject. If you have a goal of taking up higher studies in the IT field, you want to go for BTech, you want to go for BE maybe, or BCA, then which ultimately can lead to a profile, a career profile of you being a data analyst, a data scientist, data mining, data warehousing. These are various fields where IP as a subject is greatly going to help you, right? Then if you are very much interested in any subject, but not in making a career in the IT field, doesn't matter, this subject will still help you stay in sync with the latest trends in IT. Right? Because it doesn't have only programming, it has other concepts also, as we saw. It's a very scoring subject, because yes, theory is there for 70 marks, you've seen. But again, since it's an application-based subject, a lot of questions in theory also are based on the application of the knowledge which you have learned. So that makes it a very scoring subject. And lastly, all you need is 30 minutes per day to be able to score a very good percentage and to get a complete grasp of the subject, not more than 30 minutes per day. Since it is totally new for you, this is the minimum which is needed. And just a line of caution, the students who should not take the subject is those who think the subject is just like playing online games. So you think it's a computer subject, to kuch nahi hai, aram se karna hai. Please don't think that. Or those who think that theek hai, exam se ek ya do din pehle padhenge and we'll be able to, you know, score good marks. Pass the way jayenge. If you have that approach, please refrain from taking this subject. Otherwise, all the best. And let's see if you have any other questions. I'll be glad to take it. But please put it to Mansi ma'am later through that Google form, which will be shared with you all. That's all from my side, Mansi ma'am. Thank you very much. Over to you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I have one question. So those who want to do engineering after 12th, so is it like if whosoever is studying IP in 11, 12, the most of the syllabus covers in the first year in BTech, right?
Right.
All right. So those who want to do engineering, they will have an added advantage if they take IP.
Absolutely. They'll have an added advantage because one, it introduces them to the concept already in 11th and 12th. And then they also, maybe perhaps during the course of study, they realize that they have the interest in this only, so that they can take up engineering in computer science field only perhaps. And even if they're doing engineering in any other field, they can take this as a minor subject.
Okay. All right. Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. Students, if you have any question, please write it down. I'll share the Google form and then you can write the question there and we will sort out all your problems. Moving on, next we have Vandana ma'am, and she'll be talking about business studies.
Good afternoon, all of you. Today, I'll take you to a virtual tour of one of the very renowned and successful business organization, where German, the main character of the story, works there as the general manager. So I would really want you to just see this particular organization and their style of working. We'll be right back. students, what did you see, which all departments did you find in this particular organization? I would really appreciate if you just type your answers in the chat box.
Chat has been disabled as of now. Okay. They can raise their hand and Nilima ma'am can unmute them.
Okay. So if anybody has seen the video and if you know which all departments were there in that particular organization, you can raise your hands. Even teachers can participate in this. Yes, any one of you?
Ma'am, HRD department was there.
Okay, very well said. Definitely there was then, human resource department. Yes.
Finance department was there.
Finance department was there. Yes, very well said. Is there any student who has seen the video very minutely? I would really appreciate if students answer to my question. Yes, any student?
One department was administration.
Yes, very well said. Administration was there. Very well said, Amishi. Any other child?
There was one production department.
Yes, there was production department. And Nile, you have also raised your hand. So yes, I would really want to hear from you.
Ma'am, there was public relations.
Ma'am, there was one funding department. Ma'am,
finance department, very well said.
Yes.
So you have very rightly said or mentioned all these departments which were part of that organization. So children, all these departments, they work combinedly for the success of the organization. Okay. And let me ask you one more question. Did you notice something in that organization? Definitely there were many departments, but what was there in the departments? What was happening? Was there something you noticed? Or you have any idea how combinedly the success is achieved? Is there only one particular department that was working, or how, what do you think? Any idea? Anybody who has any idea, just raise your hand. Nishit, you have raised your hand. So would you like to volunteer?
Cooperation means even if one department stops working efficiently, then the whole business is affected as a whole.
Very good. So that means teamwork is very important for the success of the organization. So all these departments, they combinedly, they work under the guidance. I am just telling you the story of German, right? So all these departments, they were working together under the guidance of German, the general manager, and they keep contributing to the success of this organization. But the story was not the same 7 years back. The company did not have sufficient funds. Customers were always complaining. No creative products were there, and employees were just working for their personal benefits. Then German, he joined that organization as the general manager. He created an atmosphere where every individual was important. Coordination and teamwork flourished. And he continuously motivated people to work efficiently, which changed the faith of the company. He not only applied all that he learned in business, but also abreast the employees with the corporate culture and prepared them for their professional life. This is all you are going to learn in these 2 years of business studies. This subject has two categories. You'll have 80 marks paper in theory and a very interesting project to do, which holds 20 marks. Thus, I can say that business studies not only helps you to understand the basic operations of business, but also develops your critical thinking skills, decision making, problem solving, and helps you to understand the impact various businesses can have on society and the quality of our lives. I'm sure some of you must have the passion of making videos, designing buildings, playing basketball, or any other game. whatever your interest is, there is business side to every equation. Business is the part of that language that we use when we talk about entertainment profits, project financing, and sports marketing, and many more. Children, every industry needs marketers, financial analysts, managers, administrators, and the knowledge of this subject will broaden your horizons and support you to choose your career in marketing, finance, law, human resource, merchandising, company secretaryship. You can also opt career in chartered accountancy. You can become financial advisor, investment banker, retail manager, budget analyst, and many more. And if you really want to add value to your family business or launch a startup, then this subject is the right choice. So with this, I bring my session to an end. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. The one thing I really loved was how you explained that apart from doing CA, you can do all other things too. So basically, if somebody wants to go in commerce, they can also apply for other things rather than just being CA. So student, this is a very important thing. Please, you need to understand this, that yes, there are other fields also. If you're going to study BST separately also, there are multiple options that you can go into. Thank you so much, Vandana ma'am. Moving on, now we have Anupa ma'am, and she's going to talk about accountancy.
Good afternoon, everyone. So let's talk about the subject, accountancy. Like the salt is very important ingredient for food, likewise, accounting is also very important in our life. And it is one of the important subjects in the commerce field. So let me share the screen with you. I hope my screen is visible. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let's talk about the subject, accountancy, and the subject code is 055. So let's talk about accounting. What is accounting? So the first question arises in my mind, in your mind, is what do you understand by this term accounting? Whatever we spend in our daily life, amount of money, whatever we spend in our daily life or we earn in our daily life, it is and I write it on a piece of paper, it is accounting. So if I talk about any housewife is recording, it's her savings or maybe what daily expenditure she is doing, it is accounting. Then if I talk about you people, like as a student, you people are getting pocket money, right? So if I talk how much pocket money you get, say 1,000 rupees per month, the amount you are spending and amount you are saving for your future thing that I'm going to have a party or any picnic, that is accounting. So whatever you do in your daily lives with the amount you are getting in your hands and recording anywhere, it is called as accounting. Okay, so this is, and basically if I talk about organization, so it is a system that is providing you information about the business transaction and which helps the users of accounting information that is the people who are interested in your organization, maybe an investor, a banker, or any taxation authority. So accounting helps them that how much profit that entity has earned. Okay, so what do you think? What is the need to learn accounting? See, students, be it any profession, say if I talk about doctor, any engineer, or a teacher, or any businessman, only they all should have the knowledge of accounting, because people are earning, but they don't know how much to spend, where to spend, where to save, where to invest. So accounting helps them to get into that knowledge, okay? So it also helps the organization to track and understand the performance and will help you to make the more strategic decisions. Okay, then The scheme for study in class 11th and 12th is the theory part contains of 80 marks and the practical, that means a project work, is of 20 marks. So what will you learn in accounting in class 11th and 12th is that, so first is in class 11th, you will be learning the basics for accounting. The basics of accounting in this, you will be studying what do you understand by accounting. Then what? Who are the users of accounting? Like medical field, it has its own terminology. The accountants also have their own terminology. So terminologies for accounting, we'll study that. Then we'll study about the concepts of accounting, the real rules of accounting, then depreciation, rectification, and many more things. And the another important part we will be studying is financial statements of sole proprietorship. In this, it will help you to calculate the profit earned by the firm. Then in class 12th, you will be learning about the accounting in partnership firm and accounting for companies. Then what are the courses offered in accounting? It is like CA, everyone knows about it. But then now the new course has been offered by the ACCA, that is Association of Chartered Certificate Accountants. But in this thing, it is a global professional accounting body. That means if you opt for this option, ACCA, then you can be a CA, a finance manager, or anything in the international level. That means you can go UK, you can go USA, then Dubai, Singapore, and many more countries. Then you can go for taxation services. It is a government service and it is very good. You just need to give only one exam and you are done with this taxation thing. Then you can go for banking services. You can be accountant consultant, then the financial analyst, then the investment banker. Okay, now the school is offering you the FMM subject also, right? The school is offering you the financial markets management subject also. What is the advantage of studying this financial market management and accountancy together? First is you have a flexible career path. You could head in a completely different direction. You can be a business development manager, a data analyst, then a CA, a stockbroker, and most important, a forensic accountant. Forensic accountant. See, many companies are having frauds in their business, right? So this forensic accountant is the person who manages these frauds and solve these financial crimes. So you can go with this. Then if you have, then another advantage is that you have a high earning potential. You can get high salaries if you have both accounting and finance together. Okay, then another important thing, every industry needs accountant and finance experts. So companies from all the industries require accountants and finance professionals to manage their finance. So high demand for accounting and finance graduate means you will have a strong job security. So there is a point that is job security. So if you have accounting and FMM together, will give you an added advantage in your career path. That means you don't have to run here and either you'll do just CA. But if you are going for finance also, you can be a stockbroker. And it is, let me tell you, a stockbroker is nowadays is earning very much because they are having many more courses. Like if I talk about one GTF app, it is a proper finance app. That gives you the knowledge of the how to invest in which share or anywhere in any company. So it is a good app to learn about finance. But for that, you should have a basic knowledge. And this basic knowledge you will be learning in this subject, that is financial market management. Only finance is not enough, but you have to learn for accounting as well. Because if I talk about one example, one of my known is an IIT engineer, but he did an MBA and now he's working as a finance manager at a good post in one of the MNCs. So it is not key only engineering can be done. You can, with the engineering thing also, you can do this this finance work off with the finance thing also. So each field can be added with accounting and financial market management. So that's all from my side. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Ma'am, there is this myth, I won't say myth, just correct me if I'm wrong, that there's a lot of maths in accountancy.
No, no, it is not so. It is not so. Accounting is all about its terminology. Only a basic calculation is needed. And I hope everyone knows that how to add and subtract. That's it. There is no mathematics in accountancy.
All right. Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Okay. So next we have Praneet sir for economics. Praneet sir?
Praneet sir, you need to unmute yourself.
Sorry. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Good afternoon to each one of you. My name is Praneet, and I work with youngsters and impressionable minds such as yourself. And I try to broaden the horizon about a subject called as economics. See, I'll not be burdening all of you with any technical jargon. I'll come straight to the point. We have seen that Abhi Sakrat gayi thi, why are we banning Chinese manja? Or Holi is just around the corner. Why will we import gulal, which is used as a color from China? Why do we import firecrackers from China? Or why is it so that suddenly Apple has decided to assemble its phones in India? Or Samsung has shifted its global manufacturing base of screens from China to India. The Nikes or the Reeboks that we all are using, they are manufactured in Vietnam and Bangladesh. Essentially, they are all American brands. Jo Bose ke aap sound system sunte hain, they are manufactured in Mexico, not in America. Why are people hoarding their money in Swiss banks? Why is it happening like that? और अभी पैंडेमिक के दौरान आपने देखा होगा शेयर मार्केट इज गोइंग अप एंड पीपल आर बिकम मल्टी मिलियनर्स विद इन अ शॉर्ट स्पैन ऑफ वन एंड हाफ इयर्स अभी दो तीन दिन पहले मार्केट क्रैश भी हो रहा है धीरे धीरे सी दिस इज बेसिकली द सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स व्हाट डज इकोनॉमिक्स डू इट एक्सप्लेन्स टू यू हाउ प्रोड्यूसर्स टेक डिसीजंस रिगार्डिंग देयर एक्टिविटीज how we tend to consume goods and services. At your level, at the 11th and the 12th level, what happens is we have microeconomics and we have statistics. And at the level of the 12th standard, we have macro as well as Indian economics. Now, economics can be studied in two ways post your 12th standard. It could either be in conjunction with a subject, with another subject, for example, mathematics. Or it could be purely economics. Now, what are the career options that we have? Traditionally speaking, we have our BCom, Bachelor of Business Administration, Chartered Accountancy, ICWA, then moving on to MBA. And this reminds me, we have an integrated 5-year program being offered by Indian Institute of Management, Indore. Wherein after the 12th standard, you just have to give an entrance examination, which is very challenging. And then you get into IIM Indore and you graduate as an MBA from that place. Then another very recent phenomena is actuaries. Actuaries refers to the insurance sector. The penetration of insurance in India is close to 10% only. This means that we have an untapped market of 90% of the population being uninsured. That is why actuaries in India, the insurance sector is a very, very upcoming field. Then we have masters in finance and control, masters in management services. You could be a stock market financial analyst also. You could be trading in derivatives, financial instruments. And if you decide to just pursue economics, teaching is one profession, obviously. Research is there. Reserve Bank of India calls for economists to take its policy decisions also. Then we have economic journalism also. Aap जर्नलिज्म परस्यू कर सकते हैं इकोनॉमिक्स के साथ में, और यू कैन राइट आर्टिकल्स. देन देयर इज अनदर फील्ड विच इज ओपन फॉर यू विच इज कॉल्ड एज बिहेवियरल इकोनॉमिक्स. वॉट वी डू इन बिहेवियरल इकोनॉमिक्स इज दैट वी यूज द टेक्निक्स ऑफ साइकोलॉजी एंड कॉग्निशन टू मॉडिफाई द बिहेवियर ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल विच विल सूट द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. आपको एक छोटा सा एग्जाम्पल देता हूं, यू माइट नॉट हैव नोटिस्ड दीज थिंग्स. यू वॉक इन टू रिलायंस फ्रेश और फॉर दैट मैटर एनी सुपर स्टोर. सबसे पहले जब आप एंटर करेंगे तो यू विल फाइंड लॉट्स ऑफ चॉकलेट्स, नमकीन, बिस्किट्स, रोज एंड रोज. वॉट हैपन्स, वॉट आर दीज पीपल डूइंग? These organizations, they are molding your behavior to suit their interest. They want you to spend money. Or wo kya kar rahe hain? They are creating an environment for you. They are using your the marketing and the advertising and the visual techniques so that you tend to spend more in such places. Take another example. Why is the government promoting electric vehicles? Why has the government kept the prices of petrol at 107 rupees per liter? Uska reason ye hai ki obviously the government is earning a tremendous amount of money. The cost of petrol is only around 25 rupees per liter. The rest of the money we all are paying from our pockets to the central government and the state government. The Rajasthan government is making around 36 rupees per liter of petrol as tax, which is VAT. Now, what is the government doing? It is promoting electric vehicles so that the people start using electric vehicles instead of petrol, realizing the cost benefit analysis. That is, you spend more on petrol, EV or electric vehicles or scooters, they are going to be cheaper for you. So, hum log kya kar rahe hain? Behavioral economics ka istemal karke आपका बिहेवियर मॉडिफाई कर रहे हैं सो दैट द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया स्पेंड्स लेस मनी ऑन इंपोर्टिंग ऑफ क्रूड ऑयल. मैक्सिमम जो इंपोर्ट हमारे जो वैल्यू है इन आर इंपोर्ट बिल एवरी ईयर दैट इज फ्रॉम द क्रूड ऑयल ओनली. देन देयर इज अनदर इंटरेस्टिंग ब्रांच कॉल्ड एज एनवायरमेंटल इकोनॉमिक्स विच टीचेस यू द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ प्रोडक्शन एंड कंजम्पशन ऑफ अस ह्यूमन बीइंग्स that we are having on in the environment. Suppose there's a nuclear disaster, what effect will it have on the environment? So economics is a very wide subject. And when it is combined with other subjects, for example, mathematics, statistics, it can lead to analytical and reasoning part also. Please remember that. Another career option that is there for you is the Indian Statistical Institute, which is a premier institute in the country. For pursuing your degrees in statistics, there is a combination called as econometrics, that is economics plus mathematics, which the field of finance has got tremendous opportunities for. I think this is enough from my side, ma'am. Any questions, you're most welcome to ask.
Sir, do we have any project work in class 11, 12, NECO?
Ma'am, we have 20 marks of project work in the 12th standard and 20 marks of project work in the 11th as well.
All right. So it is 80-20 ratio.
80 and 20 ratio.
Ma'am. All right. Okay, sir. Thank you so much. I would just like to add two things here. A, I am really happy what sir mentioned that ECO can be, anybody can take it. Science student can also take it. It comes to commerce. Commerce can also take it. Humanities can also take it. The behavioral and the psychology, behavioral economics, it's brilliant. Also, we are going to conduct, after the both of the session are done, orientations are done, we are also going to conduct something called liberal arts. It's a new field where you can take any subject that you want and pursue it. If you want to take up psychology and eco after 12th and entrepreneurship or maybe accountancy, you can also do that. So that we are going to do it after these two orientations have been done. One more thing, if you specifically want to go for eco-economics, please take maths, not applied maths. Because most of the colleges do want eco with maths, not applied maths. Okay, then moving on, we have now Priyanka ma'am for entrepreneurship.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Priyanka Negi Mathur. I'm PGT Commerce. And today I'm going to tell you more about the subject entrepreneurship. So I'll just share my screen with you all. Is my screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. So children, what is entrepreneurship? This question, you know, must be there in your mind since a long time. Why entrepreneurship? Why? How is it different from the regular business, right? So today I'm going to tell you more about it. So entrepreneurship, when we say children, it's like in a layman's term, I'll explain you. It's like a ship, you know, that has on board innovative and creative men and women who like to do very, very constructive things. Like they don't need to be told by others what to do. They do everything by themselves, what passion they have. They're very passionate about their work, all right? And they try it hands-on. They're doing it. They create a prototype. Before switching to the regular business, they first make a prototype, a sample of it, and then they go ahead with the business. So successful entrepreneurs, they first identify the idea from the environment, right? So, and then they convert that idea into a viable business opportunity, right? This all you'll be studying as we proceed along with your syllabus in 11th and 12th, right? And then when they have identified the idea, converted into the opportunity, they test the viability of the idea by making a business plan. Right? How to make a business plan? This also you're going to study in 11th and 12th. In 12th, you're going to actually make it. We'll start from the 11th only, and you'll be identifying an idea, converting into an opportunity, and seeing the various aspects of it. You'll be making the business plan, putting various resources into place. Yes. And finally, if you wish, you can proceed with the idea, which I'll be telling you. Some of the students did go for the idea. So when we say, you know, the subject entrepreneurship, what is the main aim of the subject? The main aim of the subject is to instill and kindle and, you know, cultivate entrepreneurial mindset in this amongst you all, so that you have that bent of mind that you think from out of the box. It's not the regular things which are going on in the regular business, what people have been doing since ages, right? You probably all, most of you must be from business families, but then do something different, maybe in the same business, but do things differently. Okay, so one of the main, you know, very good thing about objectives, when we speak about objectives of entrepreneurship, you create self-employment, right? You are self-employed, you are a job provider, a job creator, instead of being a job seeker, right? Because you have your own startup. Right? And this, children, is also a life skill, right? You're solving by being a job provider, a job creator. You're also solving the biggest problem of our nation, which is unemployment, right? So, and thereby you're helping to with at a great extent towards building an economy, the nation, the growth of the nation. So that way also this will help you. Let me take you through the course structure. But before that, children, I would like to tell you that the curriculum has been reduced. It's not vast anymore. 3 years back, I know it was, the course content was vast, very vast. But then CBSE, we have been giving them feedbacks. So CBSE has now, 3 years back, they've reduced the curriculum. So it's not too much. A lot of things which you'll find in the book have been deleted. Okay. In class 11th as well as in class 12th. All right, so don't worry about the curriculum, the course content. Now let me take you through the course content of class 11 first. So entrepreneurship, as you can see, theory, we have 70 marks, and project, we have 30 marks. It's divided into 70-30 ratio. And then in 11th, I'll just tell you the gist of it, what you're going to study, what you'll first learn who is an entrepreneur. What are the various functions of an entrepreneur? Because here the entrepreneur is the only person who's taking care of everything, right? So he has to be a manager. He has to be a leader, a motivator, risk taker, right? So you'll learn about different functions. then you'll also learn about different traits of an entrepreneur, different attitudes, different styles of entrepreneurs. Because entrepreneurs, some are laggards, you know, they don't try to enter into risky businesses, right? They don't take risk. Some are risk bearing. So you learn all about that through beautiful case studies. This all experience will be a practical experience. As we proceed, you'll also study about the case studies. Some of you might have heard about Mrs. Leela Bordia. Yeah, she's the owner of Jaipur Blue Pottery, right? So we'll do a beautiful case study. We'll study, along with the course, we'll do the case studies. Also, Ms. Malti Modi, she is into Uma Foods, right? Then you'll also, as we proceed in the chapters, we'll do a story of KFC, how KFC was formed. You'll also become a problem solver and an innovator. You'll understand the market, how the market functions. You'll learn more about e-business. You'll learn about e-commerce, which is the trend right now, right? So you'll understand the whole market, how the whole market works. Then when we come to the, especially I'll talk about Unit 6 because children often are afraid of this, that, you know, why arithmetic, why maths? So children, no amount of maths is involved here. Few numbers are there, formulas are there, which are very easy, which you use in your day-to-day life. The cash, you'll be told about cash inflow, cash outflow, how to keep a track of cash. In any business, you have to maintain cash, like the other teachers also spoke about from commerce. Yes, so you will deal with those small transactions. Okay, you'll be told how to make the income statement. Then from where to get the fundings, from where to arrange, because finance is the lifeblood of any business. So from where, whether from capital market, whether from angel investors, you people must have heard about angel investors, venture capitalists, everything will be explained to you. So please don't worry about that at all. Then in 12th, if we speak about, again, theory and project, we have 70-30 ratio. Here, children in class 12th, the course has been designed very beautifully, and it's in sequence. It goes in sequence. First, you learn about how to change the idea into opportunity, which I told you earlier. Then you learn about how to spot the trend, what is in trend, and what you should do, what idea you should go for, which will be successful, which will be viable. Commercial viability also we need to check. Then we'll be studying, once you're done with the idea, you've selected the idea, next step would be planning. Planning in the sense about the product, about the service, and also about what type of enterprise you'll be into, whether it will be partnership, sole proprietorship, and to name a few. Then after you settle in the business, right, you need marketing strategies. Yes, so the four P's will be taught to you. When we proceed, when you've reached a level where you are getting your profits, you need to expand. Everybody looks for expansion, growth. So you'll be taught various growth strategies. So if, you know, to name a few, you will be taught franchise. What is franchise? Types of franchise. You'll be taught about mergers. You'll be taught about acquisitions. And what are the reasons? You must have seen, you know, a lot of big companies, they merge together. They do a joint venture. Then you find acquisitions also taking place. Sometimes they are forcibly also done. Yes. So, and towards the end, then you'll be told about from where to get the capital. The main thing, whether through angel investors or, you know, through VCs, the venture capitalist, or through the capital market, right? So this is regarding the course content. So just I want to say to you all, if you want to be your own boss, if you want to be a job provider rather than a job seeker, so look up for that idea, convert it into an opportunity and go for it. Okay, and before I end, I would like to share with you all that, you know, children, some students from our school, the Palace School, they have successfully started their own ventures and they are doing it. So to name a few, I'll first, there's Shruti Mehta, if you know, she's running her initiative on online mental health. She has her team of counselors who give counseling to various people around the mental health, and, you know, in the present scenario, the corona thing, the COVID, people are really upset. They need counseling. Yes, even children for that matter. Then we have Sachi Badaya. She has her own label, garments label by the name of Bissau. We have Radhika Agrawal. She is into the manufacturing of bags. So her business was actually her it was a family business. But then now she's taking it a step further. She is coming out with those hand block printed bags. So which is a nice thing. You're taking your business to a next level. Then we have Yashodhara Purohit. She has her label Yacho. This is also into garments. And we have Muskan Saraf. And she is into silver. She's doing her work, her family business. She's taking it step further. So, and you know, children, she did her project on this only. And I'm so happy, so glad to know that she's taking it further. And then we have our budding entrepreneur, Shresht, the first head boy. Yes, he is taking care. He's trying to build up. He's a budding entrepreneur for a cafe. So these are some success stories. Mansi ma'am would like to add on them.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Yes, ma'am is absolutely right. There are a lot of students. These are the handful of students that we have spoken about, but there are a lot of students who have started something of their own and they are pursuing it. Some of them are into fitness and they have started their own fitness journeys, and there they are helping other people to get more fit in their life. So there are n number of students who are doing absolutely amazing in their life on their own. But I have another question which a lot of students have been asking me. Is EP very lengthy?
No. I cleared it in the beginning only, Mansi ma'am. And children also, please, it's not lengthy. Okay, earlier it was, I agree. You know, first two batches, it was lengthy. But then the request went from the teacher's side, all the teachers from all the schools everywhere in India. And then the course CBSE actually realized and they have reduced. And this is not the reduced course due to this corona situation which happened, you know, the deleted topics. No, I'm not talking about that. That is deleted for everyone, all the subjects. But then even before that, like 3 years back, I'm talking about the course is tremendously reduced. So don't worry about that.
All right. Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Just one more thing. So with EP, so the students can have a broader area open after 12th through business, through commerce and through humanities both?
Yes. It's open, this subject entrepreneurship. It's open to all the streams. So we had a student from science in entrepreneurship. We have, you know, the toppers from humanities most of the time. So humanities, if you're opting for, don't, you know, think that it's a commerce subject, we won't be able to do, and, you know, we won't be able to solve the numericals and all. Please, no. So, you know, in entrepreneurship, we have little bit of economics, we have little bit of business studies, we have little bit of accountancy. It's a beautiful subject, beautiful course content.
Right. Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Now, lastly, we have Sanjay sir for maths and applied maths.
Good afternoon, children. So let's talk about maths and applied maths. So a very great question, like so many students personally call me for this also. I would like to start with my presentation first. So I'm sharing my screen over here. I hope you can see the screen. Yes or no? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's start with the presentation. So first of all, as you all know, like many teachers over here also said so many things about this subject. So again, but in between, they have mentioned many things, like especially Praneet sir, he has mentioned that how maths and economics, they're correlated with each other. How, like, say, in accountancy, again, a small factor of maths is there. In EP, even, like, say, small factor of maths is there. So every subject, whenever you talk about something or the other, a maths factor is always there. Like, why is it so that maths factor is there? Because everywhere you see the maths part. So basically, maths is enhancing your calculation skills, critical reasoning, thinking, logical skills, special skills, and IQ scores also. So whosoever is like, say, wants to, like, there are two subjects which I normally say that development of a gray material, that is normally done by two subjects, that is physics and the mathematics. Other subjects also contribute in it, but yeah, a lot of things, like, say, these two subjects are the major subjects where a lot of thinking is required. But these are not very difficult subjects if you go step by step, okay? So first of all, we'll talk about the two different subjects which we CBSE is offering for class 11. That is maths, core maths, which is the subject code is your 041. And the second subject is your applied maths. One great question that are these subjects same? No, the answer is specifically no. These are two different subjects, mathematics and applied mathematics. And you can see the subject codes over there also, that for mathematics it is 041 and for applied mathematics it is 241. Now, what is the basic difference between these two subjects? So, and when this first subject was introduced, actually in 2020, CBSE, like applied mathematics, first of all, it was a skilled subject previously. It was not a main regular subject. But in 2020, that skilled subject was abolished, and in place of that, applied mathematics was introduced as a main subject, elective subject. Now, why was the need of this applied mathematics? Actually, what happened, there was a great vast difference between the syllabuses which are covered. Actually, in core maths, if you see, core maths is basically meant for those people who are generally going for science streams or some specialized courses in honors, especially eco honors, or you can say like say honors in mathematics. So for those people, or say science people, all the science, mathematics, engineering sides, they require this particular kind of syllabus. Whereas those students who want to go for, or those who study mathematics previously before the applied mathematics was introduced, so they are all to study all these topics which are like say trigonometry, binomial theorem, MI, principles of mathematical induction, 3D geometry, vectors, inverse trigonometry functions, which was of no use to them. So if you see these things when they were being taught over there in class 11th and 12th, that was just a, like say, okay, enhancing their brain, but in practical life, it was not being used anywhere in their future studies. So that's why what CBSE has decided to introduce one more new subject that was named as applied mathematics. And in that core, in that particular subject, the topics which they're covering, that is basically quantitative aptitude maths is there, reasoning maths is there, detailed statistics maths is there, financial mathematics is there, logarithmics, number systems, all these things which are very useful for them at different levels, that was introduced and such a curriculum was made for applied mathematics. So this is a basic requirement that, okay, the students of commerce and students of humanities, if they want to go for mathematics, then they should definitely go for these things. Like the thing which they, whatever they should study, that should be carried forward to their future studies, and they should be beneficial in their future studies also. Like I'll just come across to the things that where actually these standard mathematics are required. So as I've said that mainly standard mathematics, or say mathematics 041, that is specifically required for engineering courses, especially science maths students going for any B.Tech or BE degree. Then in NDA, suppose if anybody wants to go for, then in NDA what happens, there are three streams we have, wings we have, Army, then Air Force and Navy. Especially in Army and especially in Navy and Air Force, standard mathematics is required. Remember that. For Army it is not required, only 10 plus 2 level is required. But for Navy and for pilot, like say for Air Force, mathematics is required. So PCM is required actually, because they want the engineering students to opt for this Air Force and for Navy courses. Then mathematics honors, that is required.
Sanjay, sir, yes. Have you moved the slide forward? Because we cannot see the slide moving forward.
By the arrow key. You can't see the slides right now?
No, sir. Actually, we are seeing the presentation, we are seeing the PPT window, not the presentation window. So we can see only the first slide. So that's what I realized.
Okay, I'm sorry for that. Just wait a moment, please.
Sure,
I'll stop my sharing then in that.
Sure, sir. Sure.
Again, I'll present my presentation.
Yes, sir.
Sir, meanwhile, can you just tell the students what is the course content that they will be studying in class 11, 12?
Okay. So basically in class 11th and 12th, normally in stand maths, if you see, you will have some kind of, broadly you can say algebra part, then you have calculus part. Just a moment, please. Let me just... Is this slide is now moving? Yes or no? Please tell
no,
me.
Sir, no, we cannot see the slideshow. We can see only the present PowerPoint window.
Okay.
So aap PowerPoint window pe sa slides niche kar lijiye. You can just do this here only. You can maybe click on the fourth slide on the left side and we'll be able to see the next slide. On the left, yeah, from here you can scroll down. Yes, you can just click on the fourth. Yes, sir. Now we can see the slides on which you are clicking.
Okay, so this is visible to you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you so much.
Yes, sir. Now we can see as you move to the slides. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, right. Sorry for this problem. So again, I'll come to this differences between the contents of both the subjects. Like in core maths, if you see, you can see these topics which we will be covering in class 11, especially trigonometry, binomial, principles of mathematical induction. Means you can divide them into units. Like algebra, you have sequence series, then you have binomial, then you have permutation combinations. Some topics, they are common for applied mathematics also, like say the permutation combinations. And you can say sequences and series. These are some common topics. So, but like say some of the topics which are not specifically for science students, that is for like say trigono or say binomial or say 3D geometry class 12th, we will be having vectors, we will be having in class 12th even again. Inverse trigonometry functions again for class 12th again. So these are some specific topics which are specially for the science students mainly. Okay, these topics, they have no use for commerce or the humanities students. So this is the basic difference between these two. And if you see the detailed statistical study which we have in applied mathematics, that is of great use for these commerce and the commerce students especially. Financial mathematics needed for everyone, like say a good idea about everything which you learn or do in the market, like say economics also, if you see, this financial mathematics will be a very great help for you. So logarithmics, number system, these are the tools by which you can ease the calculations. That is again very helpful for all of the people who are going for some bigger calculations. So quantitative aptitude, this particular topic covers a lot of different topics which are normally asked in your competitive exams, especially like say entrance exams for your CA, entrance exams for your BBA, entrance exams for your BCA. All these particular exams, they can they have this particular topic of quantitative aptitude. So this particular thing is being taught in these 2 years again. So next, basically standard mathematics, as I was saying, that who are the people who should go for it, especially those who are who are interested in going for engineering courses, or like say NDA, and NDA also there are three wings. And the first thing, like say army wing, you don't need maths for it. Without maths also you can opt for this particular thing. But like if you want to go for Navy or for Air Force wing, then in that case you require PCM. So that is must, that is a must condition for that. Then if you want to go for merchant navy courses or say pilot, like say flying simple pilot courses also, if you want to go for, again you will be requiring science background for that. Mathematics honors, if you want to go for, definitely core maths is required. Eco honors, as specified by Mansi ma'am also, that if you want to go for any economics higher courses, definitely standard maths is required, that is maths 041, not maths 241. Okay, so applied maths will not be recognized over there. Now Indian Institute of Sciences, Bangalore. It is a very prestigious institute of India, where mostly the research work is being done. And here also, if you want to get through, then definitely again, maths and biology students both can go over there, depending upon the situation, because there is a like competition, KVPY. So this competition is for like for math students also and for biology students also. So both of these students who wants to go for, say, in research work, definitely this institute is one of the best institutes. Now, those students who want to go for abroad studies, here also, like say, many universities, they recognize or they are in need of the maths 041. They are not recognizing maths, applied maths. But yeah, it is advisable that if you want to go for this particular courses for abroad studies, you should take maths, that is maths 041. It is advisable for them, but yes, many universities outside, they even don't want maths for the admissions, but you have to search for that. Okay, so it is not like that, that who are not doing maths, they can't go for abroad studies. Yes, they can go for abroad studies, but there are, the means will be different over there. They have to go for different kind of exams, like SAT they have to go for, or ACT exams they have to appear for. And subject exams also they have to appear for if they want to go for any business schools in outside India. So these are the things for necessary for standard maths. Now for applied maths, now who can or who should go for your applied maths? Like all the people who want to go for chartered accountant course or ICWA, CS, banking, PO, government service exams, like entrance exams for BBA, BCA, or import, like say famous universities like Christ, Bangalore, Narsamungi University, or like many other universities which are very renowned and they are giving us BBA or say BCA courses. So they, as I have said earlier, that they will be conducting a aptitude exam for their entrance at the entrance level. So for that, again, you have to appear. You have to prepare for a quantitative aptitude exam, and the syllabus of that particular exam is covered in these 2 year time period only. So it's a very good thing that if you want to go for these particular universities, then it's a good time to prepare yourself within these 2 years. You don't have to specially study for the entrance exam at the time before, just before the exam. So you will get prepared in these 2 years. Some questions from Lavanya is there. So you can ask Pita, like you can write your query and then Mansi ma'am will tell us about the queries. In the end, I will take your queries, okay? Please let me complete the first. So these are some cases over there. Now the next part is like say, even the humanities people, like say NEFT, CLAT, these are some kind of exams. Again, as I've said, that the quantitative aptitude exam is there. Again, so again, the syllabus which is covered or which comes in these exams, that will again be covered in these particular, these 2 year time. So it is again advisable that you should go for these, this particular applied mathematics if you are planning to go for these competitions or for these courses in future studies, okay? Now, the important part is there that who can opt for applied mathematics? Now, applied mathematics can be applied by all the people who have studied basic math or standard mathematics, any of the topics they have studied in class 10. Either they have went for basic mathematics or either they have taken standard mathematics, both can apply for this particular syllabus for the subject. And who can opt for mathematics 041? As per CBSE rules, only the people who have studied or who have opted for standard mathematics in class 10, they can opt for mathematics 041. A common question from the students comes over that they have opted for maths, basic maths in class 10, and now they want to opt for mathematics 041 in class 11. So yes, you can opt for that, but there is a simple procedure for it. So you have to reappear for the exam for standard mathematics, along with the like the exam which is again held for the supplementary people, like in August. It's a time period is near about August. At that moment, you have to register yourself again in CBSE for appearing for this particular subject like standard mathematics. You have to clear the standard mathematics exam, and then you can opt for 041 in class 11. Okay, so this is the basic procedure you have to follow if you have selected, or you have like you are doing basic mathematics right now. Now you have a planning for to go for 041 course in class 11. So this is the simple procedure which you have to follow. So these are the important things which I have to tell you. So I'm done with my thing. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you so much, sir. So students, if you have any question, please wait for the Google form and then you can write all the questions there. And I will be solving all your problems. So don't worry. If you want to contact the teacher personally also, we can do that. Just wait for the Google form. I'll send you in half an hour. Please write down the questions. Any questions, it will be sorted out. One more thing. EP, we are not giving EP in science this time due to some reasons. So we are not giving EP right now, but we are giving EP to commerce and for humanities. So those who are opting for commerce and humanities, they can apply for EP also. So thank you so much, teachers. It was an amazing presentation. I hope the students must have got a lot of insights about a lot of subjects. Everything was very clear, and everything whatever you have mentioned is very important. I think the students must have benefited from all the things that you have mentioned. So thank you so much. Thank you, students, for being so patient and attending all the subjects which was presented today. So thank you so much, everyone.
I think we can now request the students and teachers, we may leave the meeting, and then I'll request Nilima ma'am after 30 to 40 seconds to end the meeting. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, everybody.